Lord Lou Grade, last of the old school of media moguls and a legend in his own lifetime. He's devoted more than 30 years to broadcasting, and this evening we're dedicating some 5 hours of programmes to him and his greatest contribution to television history, ATV. So, book in for the night with ATV on BBC2.
Crossroads, may I help you? Yes, yes, it's good news for a nice change, isn't it? Well, having apparently closed down in 1988, we are open again, just for one night. Well, to celebrate the life and works of Mr. Television himself, Lord Lou Grade. Yeah, we're block booked with entertainment. Well, in a few moments, there's an A to Z of ATV, alphabetical compendium of all programmes Grade.
Stand by for action. We're about to launch Stingray.
Then
it's time to play the music. It's time to light the light. It's time to meet the Muppets on the Muppet Show tonight.
No use struggling, Mr. Cleese. You can't leave until you've done the show.
Lou's larger than life, although I doubt if he's even 5'9". He never eats butter. He gets up before the rest of the world. He smokes cigars bigger than himself. He was a mogul, I must say, and he really was Mr. Television.
Welcome to Sunday night at the London Palladium.
Lou was the Wheeler Dealer, and in my opinion, the best there ever was.
He's one of the breed that really took chances and takes chances.
I will not be pushed, filed, stamped, indexed, briefed, debriefed, or numbered.
I love the entertainment industry. I love people.
Remember Doors, Lou? Remember when they made proper doors? I mean, these modern doors have got no guts to them. Remember the old days when you opened a door and there was somebody behind it?
Hello, Jeff. He's standing behind the door with a bottle.
To do so much. You put on a lot of weight and you're smoking far too heavily. Bertie? Oh, my darling.
You must have an immediate operation.
Out of the question.
Sir.
No! Do you realize what happens the day after tomorrow?
It is my duty, sir.
Damn your duty! After the coronation, you can bloody well cut me in two if you want to, but not till then.
Sir, I beg you to listen.
I will be crowned. I shall go to my coronation if I die in the Abbey.
That is exactly what will happen.
And our next contestant, that's it. And it's
Leslie Walker. From where?
Already, are we, Bernie? Bung the bolt in.
All right, girls?
Yes.
All the girls in the club?
Yes.
Oh, no, not in the club, no. Anyway, the thing is, not at your time of life, I hope. Be a miracle.
So you're Mould from last week, our reigning champion. And I'm sorry, what's your name?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is... Tom Jones! It's not unusual to be loved.
by anyone.
Sonny, thank you for the truth you let me see. Yes, Sonny, I want to thank you for the facts from A to T.
Camden is an induction center for our intelligence agents.
You realize that none of the residents can leave the village, ever?
Get him out. At once.
Who are you working for?
We also have full leisure facilities, so thank you for your inquiry. What is it now, Shuey?
Mrs. Chance, this is the last straw.
That can't be possible. I'm sure I ordered 3 boxes of cheese straws.
Ah, but that wasn't taking into account an unexpected last-minute booking, was it?
Last-minute booking? Whom from?
From an old and close friend of yours. Well, perhaps no longer a friend.
To whom are you referring?
Mr. Adam Chance.
Adam? My estranged husband, who I haven't seen for several years, is coming here, to the Crossroads Motel, tonight, soon.
Indeed. Now, what's he doing here in King's Oak? That's what I'd like to know.
That's just what I'd like to know, Shuey. That's just what I'd like to know.
While I clear up the mess left by Jill's broken cheese straw, settle back and enjoy an A to Z of some of ATV's finest moments.
Stand by for action.
We're about to launch Stingray.
Annabelle.
If you think I'm going to get out of my bath to get you a cup of...
Don't be unfriendly now.
Just a minute. Just a minute. Hello? Yes, long distance. Huh? No, this is not Mr. Schwartz. You got the wrong room. You. Coming. 1 second. 1 second.
Yeah, right. What is it? Mr. Wilde? That's me. Oh.
Good Hamlet, cast thy knighted color off. Do not forever with thy veiled lid seek for thy noble father in the dust. Thou know'st 'tis common, all that lives must die.
Aye, madam, it is common.
If it be, why seems it so particular with thee?
Seems, madam. Nay, it is, I know not, seems.
Gods and devils, authority melts from me. Of late, when I cried ho like boys unto a muss, kings would start forth and cry your will. Have you no ears?
If you prick us, do we not bleed? Tickle us, do we not laugh? If you poison us, do we not die? And if you wrong us, shall we not revenge?
Some are born great, some achieve greatness. Some have greatness thrust upon them.
It is better playing with a lion's whelp than with an old one dying.
The villainy you teach me, I will execute. And it shall go hard. But I will better the instruction.
They have their exits and their entrances. And one man in his time plays many parts.
Who are you?
Jean-Baptiste Crillon de la Fort, Frenchman, swordsman, dealer in all types of goods, and captain of the good ship, Belfort.
To begin with, my beauty, I'm not a captain.
And to end with, if you're looking for a thirst, you need look no further. I'm that dry.
By the way, you didn't tell me your name.
Schulman. Captain Schulman of the Federal Police. Security branch.
I was in Germany. I'm going back to my hotel.
Huh? Well, then I better be going. Got a long journey. Mustn't keep my new masters waiting. I'll be to say.
Alan Taylor is by no means the only irreverent and controversial figure to appear regularly for ATV. Up in the Midlands, there's a gentleman called Douglas Wharf. You may have read his weekly articles in a Sunday paper. Many people hate him, many people love him, but there are very few who can ignore him.
You with your face slapping of waiters. Slapping waiters' faces all over the place.
Who told you I am?
Irritating people and getting wine thrown over you. Here in London.
But how
incident
silly.
After incident ever since you've been married to him. It's just
look,
wrecked his career.
But we do good with our money. And that's more than that thanks to us, I bet.
Look,
I'd like to know how many charities.
Let's leave all
he
these
does.
People out of it. He isn't here to answer back, and I think it's unfair.
Thank
but
God
I do say.
But I do know he's damn well looking in.
Have you got a hand to spare? Because I would I've quite like
since,
to hold it.
Listen, I've known him since I was 12. The little so-and-so. His mother and father, I think, would turn in their grave.
I want to kiss you.
What for?
Just because.
It's a pity to say goodnight, because I never saw stars so bright. But
oh,
if you gotta go, you gotta go, give me a good night kiss. It's a pity to say farewell, because the man in the moon won't tell. But if you gotta go home, you gotta go home, give me a mwah, good night kiss. Now how's about another night? Just you and me. I'll be waiting for you, baby, underneath the apple tree. It's a pity to say good night, because I never saw stars so bright. But if you gotta go home, you gotta go home, here is a good night kiss.
Kiss me, Harvey.
I'm Ozzy Owl.
And I'm Diffly Dog.
And I'm Furry Fred.
And I'm Clary Clown. Hello, folks. Nice to be moved.
And I'm Pickle-It.
Hello, Pickle-It.
Hello.
My God. Good Lord.
Hey.
Marvelous, isn't it?
Jimmy, I used to do this dance very fast.
Sure.
I want you to see how I slowed down.
Great.
Give me an introduction.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, Liberace.
Take off your hat in my presence.
Sorry, sir.
You were talking class.
No, sir.
You refused to admit it.
I wasn't, sir.
You know who was?
Yes, sir.
Who was it?
Ladies and gentlemen,
done to death, but it still catches the heart.
Ah, but it never sounds as well as when you play it.
Not on this piano. You can't get a sweep.
I'm a fool. We'll take six.
You take the ace out and hold it. Hold it face down like that. You've got the ace. Just have another look. Make sure. See?
Yes, there,
grab it. Look. And I'll take the three like that. And I'll put the two over there. Now, what have I got?
The three.
What have you got?
The ace.
I've got the ace.
How'd you do it? Oh!
Meg, I believe you run a motel. That must keep you pretty busy.
Oh, my goodness, it does, especially when business is like it is the next few weeks. We're booked absolutely solid.
And you still find time to do shopping in the town?
Well, I've got to, you see, because I've only got a teenage daughter helping me. My schoolboy son isn't a lot of use. But I've got a special do coming up, a wedding, and I'm looking for champagne and lobsters for it. So if you'll excuse me, I think I'd better get on.
Certainly, I won't keep you.
What on earth's that?
Awful's happened.
Well, come on, Gerald.
The lady on table seven, she's screaming her head off.
But why?
This.
Oh, no. Who's with her?
My mum is.
I better go through.
Mrs. Mortimer, before you go, I'd just like to say something. These are dead spiders. They didn't get there of their own accord. They've been placed there. Placed there deliberately.
That's another day, Alva. Oh, I'm washed. You know, all you do in this job is go home, go to bed, get up and come to work.
You look tired. Do you want I should make you some cocoa?
Oh, I wouldn't find now.
More tea, Mrs. Gladstone?
No. Thank you. It was lovely.
No, thank you. No.
Brandy.
Brandy.
Champagne with brandy is my favorite drink. Do you like it?
Yes, I like it very much.
You sit down, Captain Hardy. You'll have some wine. Thank you.
Askham, perhaps you would be kind enough to pull yourself together sufficiently to get me a cup of wine.
We don't buy it at the
gutter. Who turns the wine into water, madame's wine? Red Stripe?
Huh? Red Stripe, beer, beer.
Ah, thank you, Nico.
Whiskey, vodka, drambuie. Tia Maria, Cointreau, Grand Marnier.
And ale! We shall swim in it!
Sir, you make your...
Garçon, écoutez. Monsieur, mademoiselle demande que vous mélangez de... Mélangez avec beaucoup de glace.
I wish I could speak French.
Bonjour, les enfants. Ça va, les enfants? Très bien. Maintenant, regardez.
Monsieur le Président, je vous assure que votre joie ne peut égaler le plaisir que j'ai à me trouver une fois de plus dans votre chambre, mon père.
Merci. Très bien. Maintenant, regardez.
Ah, monsieur Tupin?
Il n'est pas là.
Quel dommage. Il faut absolument que je lui parle. C'est une question de l'argent. Est-ce qu'il sera là demain?
Je pense que non.
Très bien. Maintenant, regardez.
Œuf au trottoir. Eggs on the pavement. Now, but you understand.
Chacun a son goût.
Ouais.
Très bien.
Entrez.
Il s'appelle McGill, mademoiselle.
Vous pensez qu'il a des nouvelles, Stéphane?
Je ne sais pas.
Mais ce n'est pas une bonne idée.
Faites-le monter, s'il vous plaît.
Encore une fois.
Je ne le connais pas. Mais tu connais Bierce? Quelles sont tes relations avec Bierce? Faut le temps. Encore une fois.
Encore une fois.
Je suis gérant du commerce de tissu.
Parfait.
Et voilà. Une belle famille.
Quatre personnes.
I haven't got a number.
No number, no call.
Okay, now I'll tell you what I'd like you to do. I'd like you to pick an apple for me.
And have number two, please.
Two.
Number three.
Four.
And you've got yourself a prize pippin. That's a fiver coming your way.
Congratulations.
Five.
Two, four, six.
Number six, please.
Two, four, six, that's you. Six, you are six.
Name an apple leaving out, if you will, number six.
What you desire?
Number one.
I'll take you.
It's all go here at Emergency Ward 10. The girl never gets a minute to herself, never a minute's peace.
Nurse!
Oh, I'm coming. You see what I mean? Some people, really.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Lawson.
I think maybe we should try him on the cerebrometabolic regulator, sir.
What on earth is that?
Nurse, stop your chattering. Just tell them that Emergency Ward 10 will be shown on this channel soon. Don't miss it.
You gentlemen visiting Denmark, are you?
Yes, we are.
I am Alexander, Tsar of Russia. This gentleman is the Prince of Wales.
You have forgotten your place.
My Lord Southampton.
Will Shakespeare.
My dear Nelson, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you to Naples.
Thank you, Sir William. Lady Hamilton.
Ah, Captain Hardy.
My lord.
My dear Hardy. My dear, may I present Mr. Benjamin Disraeli, my wife, Rosina.
Oh, at last, Mr. Disraeli.
Sir Benjamin Disraeli, may I introduce Count Otto von Bismarck?
Your Royal Highness, I don't think you know Mrs. Edward Langtry. Mrs. Langtry. An unexpected pleasure.
Johann Strauss!
You know who I am, gentlemen?
Know who I am?
Napoleon Bonaparte.
Whoa!
Here.
£1,000.
Thank you.
You have been most grossly overpaid for a most inadequate performance.
Here, then. Here is my last sovereign.
Oh, by my reckoning, we should need to borrow another £7,650,000.
Have you money in your purse?
Half a crown, Will.
Which, at 5%, would cost us £382,500 a year.
How much does he owe you, miss?
All I want is money available. Now, let's get that first. Then argue about how to use it.
It's the easiest 50 I've earned in a very long time.
More important business permits. I'll see you tomorrow.
Now let's have that shilling.
I don't know what all the fuss is about. It's only $3 million.
Christ's become such a remote and unreal figure to most of us. A stained glass window Christ who belongs to an entirely different world. But suppose, instead of being born in Bethlehem 19 and a half centuries ago, he'd been born in this century between the wars. Christ was subjected to two cross-examinations. The first was before the Jewish authorities.
It has been said that you proclaimed yourself the Son of God. I ask you now, in the name of the Eternal, are you the Messiah, the Son? I am. You shall see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the power of God.
Key to my heart.
And if you're ever in a mess, just SOS.
If you ever feel so happy you land in jail, well, I'm your bail. It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forget, ours will still be it.
Well, if you want to laugh with gay abandon at the way a certain song's been sung, turn your radio on.
Turn your radio.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
If you want to smile with Tony Brandon, cook a recipe with Jimmy Young, turn your radio on. Turn your radio on.
I'd like to get you on a very low boat to China, all to myself alone.
Me very bad sailor.
The sea will be blue, dear, but I will be green.
Or feel so rotten, we'll have to skip the old routine.
The last.
Listen, that floats on a summer's night. That you can never quite recall. And you see Laura on a train that is passing through.
Here, I've got the picture in the house.
Those eyes, how familiar to see. She gave her very first kiss to you.
I'll never forget that first exciting kiss.
Exciting, isn't it? Excuse me, sir. We're coming into Nice Airport.
Oh, I didn't know we took off.
I think it's a wonderful sensation.
So do I, but I don't like flying.
Your first flight?
No.
Are you nervous?
Then up the plane goes in a steep climb. It banks to the right. Then to the left. 12,000 feet.
That's enough. Cool.
You're feeling a bit umpty? I'm feeling a lot umpty.
Are you feeling all right?
Soar through the air like a bird.
I like that bit.
I might drop in.
Gliding above the clouds like a god of the skies.
I like that bit.
Nothing between you and the earth below.
That's a bit I don't like.
Do you have any idea how to land this thing?
None. Absolutely none at all.
We won't be seeing the pilot in Paris, then.
No. Was that the pilot? Who said we're going to Barcelona?
It wasn't me.
But we must be on the wrong plane.
Well, you're on the wrong plane. This one isn't going to London.
We'll be landing at Gatwick in 30 minutes, gentlemen.
Well, has the captain radioed customs?
Yes, Mr. Uttershaw, there'll be a special clearance for your shipment.
Well, yes. Well, you've certainly caught me then. I'm glad I wasn't a real smuggler, as you can guess I'm not, obviously, and I'm obviously going to be fined or sent to prison. But last year, 1,100 people were convicted of trying to smuggle, which is what attempting to avoid customs duty is.
So you brought two of the boys with you, huh? Well, just let them step out the line and Lefty and the Bull.
I think you're pretty smart, huh? Louis, Shifty. Eddie. Pike.
Think.
Bust.
It's not even. These Trico people make some jolly good accessories. This is a new one, the Trico Siglet. It's the motorist lighter. Look, there's one fitted in here. Couldn't be simpler to fix on either.
Yeah, David, I'll show you. Come and have a look at this.
Hey, that's a neat looking job.
All you do is this. You just put the cigarette in like that.
Yeah.
Then you depress chromium ring here.
Mm-hmm.
Now we just wait. See the smoke starting to come.
It's working, yeah.
Filament working nicely down there. And lift the cigarette out. And there we are.
There we are. That's simple and safe enough, isn't it,
Who are you?
Never mind the questions. Hurry up and get changed and keep quiet. I'm warning you.
Matania.
Come in.
I'm warning you.
Yes, Mantania, understudy rehearsal at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning.
All right, Nicky. Good night.
That was very smart of you.
This is the business of the Indian government.
And the Chinese. We know exactly what we are doing. And Patel, this morning you assured me that he was on the run, and now you come here to meet him.
Patel is part of our plan. But it is none of your business.
By the time I got to the top of the dam, it was too late.
How did it happen?
It was an accident. He tripped over the wire.
It is meant to deceive the enemies of India.
That sounds very convincing.
You British, you never cease to amaze me.
But you mustn't take him as typical.
Only great cultures can afford to be decadent. So be proud of your miniskirt. Brag about your beetles. They are your modern equivalent of the Parthenon.
My what? Is it true your ship can sail faster than any other ship in the world?
I have never met one faster.
And that you chase the Spanish all over their own ocean?
Well, I don't think I'd better admit that, do you?
Surely it is very dangerous for you to be here in Spain. I think they would dearly like to kill you, Captain Drake.
I know they would, but I am safe, I assure you.
We escaped from the Spanish 5 days ago. They fired at us. He was hit.
Spaniards here? Yeah.
They have a gold mine a few miles away. We were prisoners working there.
Get me a Russian.
Who are you?
I'm looking for a man called Ellinger.
Never heard of him.
Jules Ellinger. Old. Walks with a stoop.
We're all old. Walk with the stoop.
Oh, what's your own name, son?
Tommy Burns, sir.
Well, Tommy Burns, incoming copy in the in-tray, outgoing copy in the out-tray, clear?
Yes, sir. I'm new here, sir.
Well, you've just picked up a trick of the trade then, haven't you? Hop in.
Marchmont Eric's home.
Oh, it's all right, Doc. I don't feel like it today.
Hey, how about this? Finer than nylon, finer than rayon. In fact, it's made of genuine cobwebs. Wear this and Eric can always be home.
No, thank you. Here, bring it back next week and I'll let you have some on the arrears.
Hello there.
Good afternoon, sir. Good flight?
Splendid, yes. Carlos Varela is the name. I have a reservation with you.
Oh, yes, Mr. Varela. The Calypso Suite.
Thank you.
Your secretary is waiting for you. She was here just a moment ago.
Good. Would you send my luggage upstairs, please?
Of course.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, Miss Carter.
Am I glad to see you?
Problems, eh?
Plenty.
Tell me all about it.
Mr. Varela, you wouldn't believe.
Oh.
Allow me.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome to Dadger Square. Now, this is the record program with a difference where we have the cats to battle with the squares over the merits or otherwise of the popular gramophone record.
Shake my head and walk away.
Oh, all right, somebody's... Ooh. Somebody has interrupted Elvis. Who did it? Stand up. Cats, we won't accept it. So I'm afraid I shall impose upon you the penalty. I must ask you to walk across to the silent booth, please. Now, will you walk across to the
silent booth?
Which is over there.
nothing to do with gin.
Now, I imagine you think you're going in there alone, aren't you? You're not, you know. You're going in there with Elvis. Go on, in you go. And that just about wipes it up. That brings us to the end of the program. I hope you've enjoyed it. It's been nice having you with us. Good night.